So our topic number one is limit definition of the derivative. The derivative of a function is the function f prime defined by f prime of x equals limit of f quantity of x plus h minus f of x over h as h approaches to 0. So our example number one is f of x is equals to 7 minus 3x cubed. To get the derivative of the given function, I use the formula f prime of x equals limit of f quantity of x plus h minus f of x over h as h approaches to 0. Separate 3 from x, then add the h to the x, then place the exponent outside the x plus h, then subtract it by the f of x, which is 7 minus 3x cubed, then divide it with h. After that, expand the x plus h from the exponent of 3 using the Pascal triangle, and you will come up with 7 minus 3 quantity of x cubed plus 3x squared h plus 3xh squared plus h cubed minus 7 plus 3x cubed, which is the f of x. After expanding, distribute negative 3 to x cubed plus 3x squared h plus 3xh squared plus h cubed. You will get the answer of 7 minus 3x cubed minus 9x squared h minus 9xh squared minus 3h cubed minus 7 minus 3x cubed. And then cancel all the like terms, which is h, and change it to 0. So our f prime of x is equals to negative 6x squared.
As what Kyla said, we need to follow the limit definition formula or the limit process. This is the example of limit process formula. So f of x equals 3x plus 2, then f prime of x equals limit of 3x plus h plus 2 minus quantity of 3x plus 2 over h as h approaches to 0. So the answer is limit 3h over h as h approaches to 0, then we need to cancel the like terms like h, so the answer is 3. So f prime of x equals 3.
So our second topic is differentiation formula. Rule number 1, constant rule. Constant rule is the derivative of a constant is 0. Example, our f of x is equals to 5, so our f prime of x is equals to 0 since 5 is a constant number. And our example number 2 is, if f of x is equals to 5, then our f prime of x is equals to 0. Rule number 2, power rule. If a function is defined by f of x is equals to x raised to the power of n, where n is any non-zero constant and x is not equal to 0 for any given n, then the derivative of f of x is given by f prime of x is equals to n times x raised to the power of n minus 1. So our example number 1 is, if f of x is equals to 5x squared, then f prime of x is equals to 2 times 5x raised to the power of 2 minus 1, and our f prime of x is equals to 10x. If f of x is equals to 2x raised to the power of 7, f prime of x is equals to 7 times 2x raised to the power of 7 minus 1. So our f prime of x is equals to 14x raised to the power of 6.
So in number 3 is constant times function. So the formula of constant times function is d over dx c times f of x is equals to c d over dx minus f of x. So the example number 1 of the constant times function is d over dx 4x raised to the power of 7. After that, 4 times quantity 7x raised to the power of 7 minus 1 is the result of 4 quantity 7x raised to the power of 6 is equals to 28x raised to the power of 6.
So the second example of constant times function is d over dx 5x raised to the power of 9. After that, 5 times quantity of 9x raised to the power of 9 minus 1. And then the result is 5 quantity of 9x raised to the power of 8 equals to 45x raised to the power of 8.
So in higher order derivatives, the derivative is the rate of change of function at a specified point. So using the differentiation rule, follow the power rule. So our given is f of x is equals to x raised to the power of 4 minus 4x cubed plus 3x squared minus 12x plus 24. So first is we're going to get the derivative of each term. F prime of x is equals to 4x minus 4 times 3x raised to the power of 3 minus 1 plus 3 times 2x raised to the power of 2 minus 1 minus 12 times 1x raised to the power of 1 minus 1 plus 0. So our first derivative is f prime of x is equals to 4x minus 12x squared plus 6x minus 12. So after getting the first derivative, follow the same process. So f second derivative of x is equals to 4x minus 12x squared plus 6x minus 12. Same process. So f second derivative of x is equals to 4 times 1x raised to the power of 1 minus 1 minus 12 times 2x raised to the power of 2 minus 1 plus 6 times 1x raised to the power of 1 minus 1 minus 0. So our second derivative, the final answer is f second derivative of x is equals to 4x minus 12x squared plus 6x minus 1. So f second derivative of x is equals to 4x minus 12x squared plus 6x minus 1. So same process. F second derivative of x is equals to 4 times 1x raised to the power of 1 minus 1 minus 12 times 2x raised to the power of 2 minus 1 plus 6 times 1x raised to the power of 1 minus 1 minus 0. So our final answer, the second derivative is 4 minus 24x plus 6. Example number 2. We need to find the fourth derivative of the given function, which is the f of x is equals to 13x raised to the power of 8 minus 4x cubed plus 16x raised to the power of 4. So the derivative of our given function is 104x raised to the power of 7 minus 12x squared plus 64x cubed. So next up, we need to find the second derivative of x, which is the given 107 times 7x raised to the power of 7 minus 1 minus 12 times 2x raised to the power of 2 minus 1 plus 64 times 3x raised to the power of 3 minus 1. So the second derivative of the given function is 749x raised to the power of 6 minus 24x plus 192x squared. So next, we need to find the f third derivative of x, which is 749 times 6x raised to the power of 1 minus 24 times 1x raised to the power of 1 minus 1 plus 192 times 2x raised to the power of 2 minus 1. So the f third derivative of our x is equals to 4494x raised to the power of 5 minus 24 plus 384x. So our final step is to find the fourth derivative of x, which is 4,494 times 5x raised to the power of 5 minus 1 minus 0, which is the 24 because 24 is constant, so we change it to 0, plus 384 times 1x raised to the power of 1 minus 1. So our final answer, which is the f fourth derivative of x, is equals to 22,470x raised to the power of 4 plus 384. So that's the fourth derivative of the given function 13x raised to the power of 8 minus 4x cubed plus 16x raised to the power of 4.
For the fourth rule, sum and or difference rule. For the sum, if f of x equals h of x plus g of x, then f prime of x equals h prime of x plus g prime of x. And for the difference, if f of x equals h of x minus g of x, then f prime of x equals h prime of x minus g prime of x. Example number 1. F of x equals 3x plus 2
Then f prime of x equals f prime quantity of 3x plus f prime quantity of 4. F prime of x equals 3 plus 0. So the final answer is f prime of x equals 3. For the second example is f of x equals 5x squared minus 7. Then f prime of x equals f prime quantity of 5x squared minus f prime quantity of 7. Then f prime of x equals 10x minus 0. So the final answer is f prime of x equals 10x. For the fifth rule, product rule. If h of x equals f of x times g of x, then h prime of x equals f of x times g prime of x plus g of x times f prime of x. Example number one, f of x equals the quantity of 6x cubed minus x times the quantity of 10 minus 20x. And then f prime of x equals the quantity of 18x squared minus 1 times the quantity of 10 minus 20x plus the quantity of 6x cubed minus x times the quantity of negative 20. And the final answer will be f prime of x equals negative 480x cubed plus 180x squared plus 40x minus 10. Sample number 2. F of t equals the quantity of 4t squared minus t times the quantity of t cubed minus 8t squared plus 12. Then f prime of t equals the quantity of 8t minus 1 times the quantity of t cubed minus 8t squared plus 12 plus the quantity of 4t squared minus t times the quantity of 3t squared minus 16t. And the final answer will be f prime of t equals 20 t raised to the power of 4 minus 132 t cubed plus 24 t squared plus 96 t minus 12.
Conclusion rule. If h of x equals f prime quantity of x 1 over g quantity of x, then h prime of x equals g quantity of x times f prime of x minus f quantity of x times g prime x and over quantity g x squared. Example number 1, g quantity of x equals 6x squared all over 2 minus x. Then g prime of x equals 12x times the quantity of 2 minus x minus 6x squared times the quantity of negative 1 all over quantity 2 minus x squared. Then the final answer is g prime of x equals 24x minus 6x squared all over quantity 2 minus x squared. Example number 2. F quantity of x equals 3x plus x to the power of 4 all over 2x squared plus 1. Then f prime of x equals quantity 3 plus 4x cubed times the quantity of 2x squared plus 1 minus the quantity of 3x plus x to the power of 4 times the quantity of 4x all over quantity 2x squared plus 1 squared. Then the final answer is f prime of x equals 4x to the power of 5 plus 4x cubed plus 6x squared plus 3 all over quantity 2x squared plus 1 squared.
So our topic for today is about chain rule, and we're going to look two examples related to chain rule, and I'm going to teach you how to solve it. Basically, when we have a composition of f of g of x, it says to take the derivative of function like this. You take the derivative of the outside function and you leave the inside one alone. The chain rule part you multiply by the derivative of the inside part. So let's begin. So this is the first example. F of x equals 2 times 6 minus x squared raised to the power of 5. Then f prime of x, bring down 5 and multiply it by 2, then we'll get 10. And what's inside will still the same, then 6 minus x squared. Then 5 minus 1 equals 4. Then multiply it by the derivative of 6 minus x squared, which is negative 2x. Then f prime of x, then combine 10 and negative 2x, so we'll get negative 20x. Then copy 6 minus x squared raised to the power of 4. Then that's the answer. So the second example is f of x equals 3x minus 1 over x squared plus 3 squared. There's no radical, so there's no need to rewrite the expression. Then since it's quotient, then we're going to use quotient rule. So let's begin by doing power chain rule. 2 out in front and copy 3x minus 1 over x squared plus 3. Then we're going to multiply the derivative of the inside, and that requires the quotient rule. So a quotient rule says take the derivative of the top 3x minus 1, which is 3, x squared plus 3, minus 3x minus 1, and the derivative of x squared plus 3. Then all over by the bottom x squared plus 3. So the next step is rewrite the first piece and simplify the numerator, and it will become negative 3x squared plus 2x plus 9 all over x squared plus 3 squared. Then combine this together, and it will become f prime of x equals 2 3x minus 1 times 3x squared plus 2x plus 9 over the denominator x squared plus 3 squared. This is the answer.
So the first example of application derivatives 2 is rate of change. So we have example number 1 right here. Suppose that a ladder of length 25 feet is placed on a vertical wall. It was then found out that the base of the ladder slides at a rate of 2 inches per minute. How fast is the base of the ladder moving away from the base of the wall? At the instance when the base of the ladder is 15 feet from the base of the wall. So step number 1, we have the working equation, which is x squared plus y squared is equal to 25 squared, which is also 625. So then the first step is we differentiate both sides. So we have dy over dt, x squared plus y squared, and is equal to dy over dt quantity of 625. So then we have 2x times dy over dt plus 2y times dy over dt is equal to 0, since 65 is a constant number. And then we have dy over dt is equal to 2x times dx over dt over 2y. And then we have the final answer, negative x over y times dx over dt. So then the second step is we substitute in the values. So dy over dt, which is, and x equals to 15, is 15 over y times dx over dt. So then we have the following equation. 15 squared plus y squared is equal to 625. And so y squared is equal to 625 minus 225, which is equal to 400. So then we have y is equal to 20. And so Next, since we already have our y, we sub in our x. So dy over dt is equal to x equals to 15, which is equals to negative 15 over 20 times 1 over 6, which is equal to negative 1 over 8 feet per minute. So here we have another example of application of derivatives rate of change. Water is being poured at the same rate of 10 meter cube per second into a cylindrical tank of radius 5 meters and altitude 20 meters. How fast is the water level rising when the water level is at 6 meters? So here we have a figure, and this shows all the variables. And so our working equation will be V, which stands for volume, is equal to pi times 5 squared times height, which is h. So here we have volume with respect to time, which is dv over dt, is equal to 25 pi times dh over dt. And so when we rearrange the equation, we have dh over dt, which is the water level of the tank with respect to time, is equal to 1 over 25 pi times dv over dt. And so since the question is asking the water level at 6 meters, so we have dh over dt, when h is equal to 6, that will give us 1 over 25 pi times 10. And so our final answer will be 2 over 5 pi meters per minute.